Hello students, today we'll be discussing another topic relevant to BVOC, which is the emergence of online media branding. First of all, how do you define online media branding? There are mainstream media branding and outdoor media branding that have been widely understood and executed before the emergence of online media branding. Now, how do you understand online media branding? It's basically the process of branding which happens using the internet-based new media. Every kind of branding that happens utilizing all kinds of internet media are basically understood as online branding. Online branding came into existence with the advent of internet and more prominently with the advent of social media, especially Facebook. Now, Facebook was the one that initially made it very easy for brands to establish themselves by providing a wide and free range of audience worldwide. However, the process has become much more challenging since. Before the advent of Facebook, experts of branding tended to go to television, radio, newspapers, outdoor branding, and other such means. But once the advent of Facebook happened, branding became an extremely easy and yet complicated process that had a wide audience provided by social media globally. Now, with the emergence of online branding, there were a couple of concepts that emerged as well, which did not exist during mainstream media branding or outdoor media branding. Let's understand those concepts which are unique to online media branding. Firstly, when the emergence of online media branding happened, all branding techniques used so far became basics. As and when we understand branding, there are a couple of elements which instantly come to our mind: a tagline, a logo, color code, an image maybe, a brand ambassador, and such things. All those elements became basics. Every single brand that started out required these elements to even just establish itself, and they were not exactly areas of expertise or advanced areas of branding. With the advent of online media branding, these terms were categorized into basics. The next point, brand consistency across multiple touch points. Multiple touch points refer to the n number of platforms provided by digital media all across the internet. There are social media, there are blogs, there are vlogs, there are discussion portals, there are online shopping portals and whatnot. All these multiple touch points pose a challenge to a singular brand which has to maintain its consistency across all the platforms. Previously, that was not the case. With the emergence of online media branding, every single brand now has to maintain its consistency across hundreds of platforms that keep evolving every single day. The next point, the idea of making the customers feel the brand through actions like brand interacting with consumers. When the branding process happened through television or billboards or through even outdoor media, there was never a chance for the consumer to interact with the brand. But with the advent of online branding, there are n number of portals that allow the brand, no matter how big it is, internationally, nationally, or even globally, to directly interact with every one of its consumers. Now, the challenge exists in the hands of the brand to interact with the consumers on an everyday basis to make sure that they are responding to our brand the way we intend them to respond and keep them happy. This major challenge came with the advent of online media branding. None of the other media allowed direct access for a consumer to interact with the brand, no matter how large it was. The next point, altering brand identities without changing them to fit into multiple platforms. Like I said, there are hundreds of platforms across digital media platforms on the internet which allow a brand to alter its identity and present itself to its target specified audience. Let's say, for example, there's a brand which presents itself as a disciplined, as a serious, or as a very concerned brand on Facebook, which has to alter its identity to a very fashionable, trendy, or even youth-appealed brand on Instagram. That is how you alter your identity. That is how you alter your identity in order to appeal to the kind of audience that you are dealing with. Every single online platform, no matter how easy it is to access, deals with a very specific type of audience. And it is the responsibility of the brand to alter its identity and definitely not change it. Alter and change are definitely two different things. Every brand has to alter its identity to fit into a specific digital media platform and appeal to the target audience. The next point, brand voice, marketing personas, and buyer personas were developed for brands considering the increasing number of times the brand had to converse to stay relevant and the ever-increasing audience capacity. The advent of these technical terms known as brand voice, marketing personas and buyer personas are very relevant today in the field of online branding especially. What does a brand voice mean? A brand voice is basically the identity of the brand which it puts forward in the form of text. A brand will always have a specific way of communicating itself to its audiences. Maybe the way it uses its sentences, maybe the grammatical inclinations, maybe the way it addresses its specific consumers, or even the kind of issues that it voices. All these decisions are made beforehand and named as a style sheet or a brand voice, which is to be predetermined before bringing the brand onto social media. Every single brand has to stick to that brand voice in order to maintain consistency and have a very firm impression on the minds of its consumers. Secondly, marketing personas and buyer personas. Let me explain that with an example. I want to open a bakery at Ujre. The rural population of Ujre does not have a lot of population, but it does have a great institution which brings in a lot of people day in and day out. So if I have to brand my local bakery online, the kind of audience that I would be drawing are students maybe, parents who come to drop the students, and maybe the localites. When I brand my bakery online, every social media platform gives me options to choose the kind of audience that I would wish to target. The kind of audience I would like to target is basically buyer persona, and every brand has to do it when it comes to online branding in order to target the right kind of audience. These technical terms of brand voice, marketing and buyer personas came with the advent of online media branding and are here to stay. Lastly, what are the factors associated with online media branding that are not associated with mainstream or outdoor media branding? A. Website development. Every brand requires a digital destination. Content development, which is a very booming field because every single day the social media handles must stay active and converse with the consumers in order to stay relevant. Thirdly, social media management, like I said, is a huge profile because social media managers are hired to make sure that the kind of audience that the brand targets are kept in loop every single day. Infographics designers, such as logo designers, color code determiners, graphic designers, etc. These are the kind of profiles that are also associated with online media branding. Lastly, digital marketing. This is actually the extended concept of digital media branding, which comes after the process of successful branding online or offline. Thank you.